All right, it's official. There's only one way to truly save Kakadu, and that is to kill Naho. Sup everyone, I'm your female Taku, and I'm going to review episode 11 of Orange. And with this episode, I'm pretty sure all of us just want to take Naho and just toss her in a cage, make sure you throw out that key to the locker and not release her because she does not know shit. Oh my gosh, Naho is so freaking frustrating. Now, I've said this before, how at least once every single episode she has like this really moment where you just want to, you know, kill her. But you know, it's becoming more and more apparent and situations have become more dire as of late for when it comes to, you know, saving Kakadu and stuff, and now I'm just making everything worse. And it pains me a little to say this because, you know, Kana Hanazawa, my favorite seiyuu of all time, voices Naho. So it does pain me a little to hate on a character that Kana Hanazawa plays, but you know what? I have to. Just so you know, Kanahana, come in this time. Before I rant even more about Naho, let's talk about future Naho. It was very interesting what she said. You see, we start off with the episode with the future gang in the car and stuff, and they're discussing about who Naho would have chosen if Kakadu was still alive, and everyone in the car, they were all like, we root for Naho and Kakadu and stuff, and then Sue was like, oh, what? None of you would root for me? And then Naho said, actually, if Kakadu was still alive, I would still choose you, Sua. Very interesting statement. Now, we can't really cross this over to the present because it's being inferred to us that there's parallel worlds. That's how the time travel works in Orange, that there's parallel worlds. So, and we also know that the future is changing. The parallel worlds aren't too connected. They're not connected that much. So I'm not too positive if current Naho would still choose Sua. However, I would prefer Naho to be with Sua because Naho needs Sua. Kakadu does not need Naho. Oh no, he does not. I mean, he legit threw his phone. He threw his phone and broke it when he saw Naho's name on the screen. It's done. Naho cannot be a part of this plan. We gotta kick her out. This boy is going to die because of her. Oh my goodness. No, Kakadu does not deserve Naho. Right now, all Kakadu needs is the power of friendship. That's all he needs. Like, legit, for once, I believe that the power of friendship is going to save Kakadu. We need the power of friendship. Screw that love shit. Screw it. We don't need this to be a shoujo romance. No. Won't just save the boy, please. But honestly, Naho was repeating the same mistakes. Has she learned nothing? The fact that Kakadu, he said that he was going to leave early and stay with his grandma and stuff because he's worried about her. Totally cool. I knew that's exactly what he was going to do and I would do the same thing. So hearing your friend say, oh no, but could you please stay longer? That's gonna piss you the fuck off. Not only that, but the same thing happened on the opening ceremony. Did Naho forget that? Cause Kakadu didn't, he brought that shit up, okay? Just, oh my goodness, no. Oh my gosh. We just get Taka in there. Taka, please, Takako. Someone bring this bitch in here, okay? Because we need Takako to smack the fuck out of Naho. All right, just Takako, my girl, she knows what's up. She knows how to do things. Forget Naho, bring in Takako, please. Oh. Gosh, I can't. I'm so frustrated right now. Okay, I think I ranted enough. Let me talk about some good points about this episode. And one thing, the Hagita comedy just keeps on getting better. I love the Hagita comedy. Whenever he banters with Azu, or when he just says things out of the blue, like this is funny. When Kakadu came over and complimented Naho's scarf, and then Naho complimented Kakadu's scarf, and then Hagita, he's just in the back there. There was a pause, and then he finally spoke up. He's just like, I'm wearing a scarf too. Just Hagita. It's not about the scarves. I love this man. Oh, he's so funny. And I love how Azu is also joking with Hagita. She's just like, oh, what is this, a married couple act? Come on. And I'm just like, Azu, you know. You know that you two should be getting together. She's cool too. And finally, Suwa comes in for the save like he always does. The letter said that Suwa was going to confess to Naho on New Year's Eve. And the gang, they're kind of bickering on whether or not he should do that, but in the end, he went over to Naho, he ditched the gang and comforted her, and instead of confessing to her, he told her to go back out there and get Kakeru back before New Year begins. Suwa, you're a strong man. You really are. You're a good man and you're a strong man. Oh my gosh, just, I'm not too sure why you would love Naho so much. Don't really get that, but Naho needs you. You don't need Naho, Suwa. And that was this episode. Let me know your thoughts with Suwa Best Boy, how Kakeru acted, and of course how Naho acted. Honestly, Naho just worst girl. Worst girl, Naho. I honestly wasn't even this frustrated with Ueda. Yeah, I hate Naho more than Ueda now. I just can't anymore. Naho just, no, I'm done. I'm ending this. Alright. Catch you later as I review ReZero and Tales of the Theory of the Cross. I'm your female otaku, sayonara.